Hey, it's Ashley with the Nerds Next Door, and today we're talking about the most useless video game characters. Let's get into it. Starting off with Tails from Sonic 2. Tails himself is not a terrible character, but in Sonic 2, he just ran around and the AI would not let him catch up with Sonic. You just see him random places, he'd hit random boxes or random enemies or more than likely get killed, or he would take your last ring. You get hit, rings scatter everywhere, you just need one, and here comes Tails, taking that last damn ring from you when you need it. Tails went on to be a better ally and help to Sonic. You see it in Sonic 3 where he could carry you, but for the time being in Sonic 2, just him following you around, completely useless. Completely freaking useless. Although he did get extra hits on Dr. Robotnik and some of the boss fights, but that's few and far between.
So this is going to be a spoiler warning for anybody that hasn't played the Walking Dead games, the Telltale Walking Dead games, even though those games are like 10 years old. But there's a character, I know this character is a kid, he's like 10 years old, but the character Duck from The Walking Dead, all this kid does is like get into stuff and get people killed. And people say, oh, he's just a kid, he doesn't know any better. But Clementine is also a kid, they're the same age, if not she's younger, and she knows better than to do all this stupid stuff, because he gets like multiple people killed. He's like, depending on your choices, he can get his dad killed, he can get you killed. So Duck is one of the worst characters, useless characters in video games.
Going to Fallout 4, Preston Garvey. Preston Garvey comes off as like this cool, competent guy that you're like, yeah, I'm gonna join his faction and be able to help people make settlements. Then he just kind of turns into like the Domino's call center, always sending you out on deliveries or missions and just like, go away. I don't want to talk to you. Do not communicate with me. Get off my Pip-Boy. We're not friends anymore. Lose my number. Always he's walking around your settlement, but he's never helping make other settlements better. You go. I'm over here fighting super mutants as it is. You go help the people set up there, because you're just hanging out in my colony already, doing nothing but telling me to go.
So when it comes to first-person shooters, one of the worst characters or most useless characters is Natalia from GoldenEye 007, because she doesn't do anything, can't fight anybody, and just runs in the way when you're trying to shoot her. And another thing on first-person shooters, almost any like military shooter like Call of Duty or Halo, even Battlefield, is the everybody but you on your side of the army, because you got to do all the killing, all the work, set all the explosives, do everything. There's always Call of Duty, there's other specialists and like generals and everything, but doesn't nobody do anything except for you. Even Killzone, it's like you and maybe one other person does everything. So every other person but you in every military first person shooter where it's that war going on, because they leave you to do pretty much every single thing.
I really, really love this game. I spent multiple hours on Oblivion trying to close those gates, running through Kvatch and all of Cyrodiil. But when you do the arena quest and you get that fan and he just follows you and he crouches down, he's scared to fight if you get in a fight. So what good are you to follow me around? Just don't need it. And if you're a thief in the game or you're an assassin, he's the eyes that are gonna tell on you and snitch on you. Also, most useless, I'm gonna throw in an extra one here. In Skyrim, your horse can rat you out and be the person who sees you committing a crime. You mean to tell me, Shadowmere, you came from the pits of hell, from the Dark Brotherhood. You watch and you're all about the Dark Brotherhood killing people, but you're gonna tell on me when I steal some cheese? No. To the glue factory with you.
So to me, one of the most useless characters in video games is Pichu in Smash Bros. Melee. I know he's got better in other games, and he's kind of you kind of need him for a Pokemon in the Pokemon games, but in Smash Bros., he's just a weaker Pikachu with the same moveset, and the thing that makes him the worst is that when he does moves, they hurt him. So all his attacks, every time you do an attack, it hurts you as well, even if you miss the attack. You're just causing useless damage to yourself. So when I was asking people who was the worst character or the most useless character, we got on the topic of Street Fighter, and people were trying to say who the worst Street Fighter character is. People were saying Zangief and other characters, but Zangief is not a bad character. Zangief is good if you know how to use him. He has the unblockable throws. But to me, Dan is the most useless character in Street Fighter in any game that he's in. Even though he can be usable, you can be good with him, but there's no reason to choose Dan over Ken or Ryu or Akuma or anybody else, because he's just a weaker version of those two. And in the Marvel vs. Capcom game, his Hadouken goes like, it goes a less distance than his hard punch, so you're just pushing the extra time to do motions. And his super moves are like taunts, which his taunt takes like 5 minutes to do, and it doesn't even hurt anybody.
The legend has now begun. Don't underestimate me. Chickening out? Psycho! Oh yeah! Too easy! Ooh! Burn this in your memory! Obtrusive!
Alright, that's it for the video. Those are the characters that we thought are the most useless in video games. Comment down below which character you think is the most useless, and if you think some of our characters were more useful than we say they were, give your reason why. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you like this type of video. We'll make some more. You can follow us on Patreon. Check out the nerdsnextstore.com if you want some merch. Thanks for watching, and peace out.